should Zion shut it down for the rest of the year?
I would advise this young man to shut it down and wait for the draft. And that's even if this just proves to be nothing more than what Coach K said it was after the game, which is a minor knee strain. Even if it's just that. This kid is, when he cuts and he leaps, he does so with such sudden explosion that even if he has a tweaked knee, even if it's just a sprain, and sometimes sprains can be fairly serious, you're set up for a fall. You're set up to risk either limiting your NBA career or potentially wrecking your NBA career for the sake of Duke University, which is paying you no more than room, board, and tuition. And I know that's a lot, and it's a great stage to be on, but it's not worth it now. I will say this, and let me point this out first. Since 2005, I have been on the record because in 2005, the league once again started forcing kids to wait 1 year. They had to be 1 year removed from high school.
I never loved that rule.
I didn't either, because they went for a long time since the Spencer Haywood versus, you know, when he took it all the way to Supreme Court. So since the early 70s, you could go straight from high school into pro basketball. That's fine with me, because what they imposed upon these kids starting in 2005 was outrageously unconstitutional. Zion and RJ and even Cam, that they could all be playing pro basketball at a reasonably high level, and they could be earning money that they won't ever be able to get back over the long haul. So the point is, did Zion benefit from playing 26 games at Duke? Yes, he did. Because remember, the scouting services before the year started did not have Zion ranked number one in the draft. They had RJ number one. Some services had Zion number two. There are a couple of services, Rivals and 24/7, had Zion ranked fifth of the potential draftees. Okay, so it served him well in his specific case to go to college and play 26 games, because he skyrocketed. And then obviously he's now the runaway number one pick. And what happened last night was his legend and his mystique took off again. Because he, as Jenny is pointing out, he is so suddenly explosive that he just blew right through a shoe. Even Nike couldn't contain Zion Williamson last night. So, again, he will take off even more in the social media highlight film, you know, the highlight of the night. He is made for this social media age. Mm-hmm. And so he's not only going to get, I think, the richest rookie shoe deal, he just might get a signature rookie shoe, because now the whole focus is going to be on shoes. Can you build a shoe that can stand up to Zion Williamson?
Maybe he'll have to play in Timberland boots.
I don't know. This mystique will grow. The legend will grow off last night. Like last night, to me, actually turned out to be the greatest thing that could happen to that kid, as long as he's not hurt seriously. And I don't think he's hurt seriously. So in the big picture, could Zion going forward benefit in basketball growth from playing on big stage national TV games for Duke University at Carolina on March the 9th in the ACC tournament, in the NCAAs, perhaps in the Final Four? Would that help him? Would that help his growth as a basketball player? Yes, it would. Mm-hmm. But is it worth the risk right now, given that he weighs 285 pounds and he is so gifted at athletic explosion? No, it's not. Because when you can jump that high and come down 285 pounds on a tweaked knee, I just don't want to see him wreck his knee. So now he's done all he needs to do. The hay is in the barn, and the money, to me, is in the bank. You cannot risk it from this point forward.
Skip, I could not disagree with you more.
Okay.
From this standpoint. And if he's healthy, and I'm talking about he walked off on his own power.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
They're not saying he didn't go in a wheelchair and mm-hmm. needed eight guys to carry him off.
In fact, ESPN reported that he was trying to jog up in the hallway.
Right.
So I'll give you that. I don't think this is serious.
Serious. If it's serious, mm-hmm. I totally agree, mm-hmm. but I don't. And when I would question an 18-year-old who doesn't want to play basketball. And I get the draft, and I get all that, and can he go any higher than one? And I get it. He can only fall back, right? I understand. But I want a guy who wants to play. This is not like the football players who do it. I get that 100%, Skip. I'm not going to play in a meaningless bowl game, right, where I could get hurt on any play. in football.
I have those problem with him saying no to that.
I respect that, right. Now, have you ever seen a guy step out and say, I'm not going to play in a national championship game because I could get hurt and blow my NFL career? Never, because you're playing for something. Duke is playing for something, Skip, this year. Yep. They could win the national championship. Why doesn't Zion Williamson want to be Carmelo Anthony? Remember, Carmelo Anthony had an unbelievable run in the NCAA tournament. People still remember that. He can hold on to that. His NBA career didn't pan out.
That's all I remember.
Well, that's what I'm saying. But that's a memory that you have that can't be taken away from you. And there was a quote last month by Zion, which I really respect. He said, quote, I just can't stop playing. I'd be letting my teammates down. I'd be letting Coach K down. I'd be letting a lot of people down. If I wanted to sit out, I wouldn't have went to college. I came to Duke to play.
Yep.
And if he's healthy, he should play. If you're asking him to tough it up and play in some NIT game or some exhibition, Skip, 100%. No way, no how should he put that on the line. But he's 18 years old. If I'm a GM and this guy really doesn't want to play and he's fine, I got a problem with it. And I question really about, is this going to happen in the pros every time he gets a little injury or a tweak or something and he doesn't want to play? I don't want guys like that. I'm not saying you should risk your career and risk further injury. He's too young, too good. I don't care where the draft stock is. You're there to play basketball. You're a player. Players play. They don't sit out. So I'm not buying that. Everybody ready to run and say, oh, he shouldn't play anymore. He's already a first overall pick. One of these other guys, Barrett or one of these other cats, could have an unbelievable run in the NCAA tournament and then say, wait a minute. This other kid hadn't played in 2 months. I really don't know. Is he okay? I haven't seen him play, but I've seen R.J. Barrett light it up. Barrett had, 30 points last night?
33.
33 points? Mm-hmm. He might light it up in the tournament, lead Duke to a national championship. And Skip, you know it's always, what have you done for me lately? That kid becomes the hot kid, and now all of a sudden, you get picked in the top five, but you're not the number one overall pick. So I think it would be a big mistake for him not to play if he's healthy.
So you're telling me, if you're the GM of the team that hits the lottery and has the number one pick, and if Zion has shut it down for the last, quarter of this season and missed all the playoff games, that you're telling me you might start thinking about R.J. Barrett if he had a great run through the NCAAs?
I would just question a little bit what this kid is made of when an 18-year-old kid doesn't want to play basketball. Skip, you love basketball. You know sports. When you were 18, you couldn't wait to play. As a kid, you wanted to get out there and play and compete. And that's all I'm saying. If you're healthy, this is not football. I get football. Every play could be career-ending. Mm-hmm. Basketball, we've seen guys with worse injuries than this rehab and come back and play. So I'm just like, this whole protecting your stock and not playing when you're in college, he should have just sat out and waited for the scouts to come by his driveway and just say, we're going to pick you because we see you dunking in the driveway.
But he played 26 games for Duke, and he played at a literally high level, and he vaulted past four kids who two services had ranked above him.
How did he vault past them, Skip? By playing.
Okay.
How
well,
can
I said,
other
but,
guys
but,
vault
but
past
again,
him?
Hayes
by
in the
playing.
Barn. He already did it, and we know he did it. And have you ever seen a 285-pounder who could jump as quickly and as explosively as this kid can?
Well, if I'm a GM, I might say, how much is this going to cost me in sneakers during a regular season?
Well, you might
that
say
might
that.
That might be a deterrent.
But do you realize how much tonnage is coming down, how hard from how high, when 285 pounds keep hitting the floor from way above the rim, where he's looking down on the rim when he does 360 reverse spin dunks in pregame warm-ups, as we saw last night? Do you know what the danger is, what the threat is to a knee? If it's tweaked right now and there's any hesitation on his part to come down full force on that, it's usually when you're trying to protect that the worst happens.
Time he does it after he gets drafted in the NBA and he does it in practice. So he doesn't do it up until he gets to the NBA and then he winds up, God forbid, hurting himself then. Then what? You're the GM, you go, maybe I should have made sure this guy played a little bit more before we just decided to put our franchise in his hands.
And let's talk about R.J. Barrett for a second because He has been highly, to me, unimpressive this year from what I thought he was going to be. Because, again, I've watched a whole lot of Duke, and I brought up yesterday when I was arguing with Chris Broussard about this, the Gonzaga game. He's the guy who wants to take all the shots, not Zion. RJ wants the basketball, and I love it because he's got, as they say, that dog in him. He wants to take and make the big shot.
But is this an incentive, Skip, for him to up his end?
Okay, but what happened for RJ against Gonzaga down the stretch, this is in the Maui Invitational, he shot the ball five times in the last minute and missed all five of them in a two-point game, and it just didn't bode well. It didn't. If I'm a GM, or any personnel director, I'm saying, man, I'm not sure about that. So his stock starts to fall, and I'm not even sure at this point he's going to be the second overall pick. And then last night, when Zion goes down, whatever it was, 37 seconds into the game, this was RJ's stage, man. You're at home against a legitimate contender, obviously. I'm not sure they're the second best team in the ACC, but they're a legit top
team. And a big rivalry game.
Yeah, it's a big rivalry game.
It's
in your house. And I know you're a freshman, so it's not really your house yet. But that was his time to rise and shine. That was Cam Reddish's night to rise and shine and say, we're good. We got this.
But didn't
especially
you think
RJ.
The shell shock of it, though,
sure.
Because it was so quick. Because I'm with you, Skip. That shouldn't have been a blowout right away. The game had just started. So they could have collected themselves, especially after they saw Zion walk off. It wasn't mm-hmm. like he was taken off in a stretcher or a wheelchair.
It wasn't. And all of a sudden, it was like RJ and Cam Reddish and all the rest of them had forgotten how to play defense. Because all of a sudden, Carolina was scoring at will in the paint. What was it?
62 points?
32 of their first 39 points, this is in the first half, came in the paint. And every time I looked up, there's a missed shot, an offensive rebound by Carolina, and somebody's just laying it in off the glass. What?
It was way too easy.
RJ, where are you? And again, I know he's not a dominant post player. He's like 6'7". He and Zion are about, I think he's probably an inch taller than Zion. But again, you got to play bigger than that against Carolina. And Luke May is a senior, so he's been around, and he's a veteran college basketball player, but he just took the game over. And RJ winds up with 33 points. And when I looked at the box score after the game, I said, he had 33? Because I can't remember two of them.
Interesting.
Seriously, because they were the quietest 33 points I can ever remember. Duke made a little run at the end of the first half, and it looked like they might cut it down to 5, 6, 7 at halftime, and all of a sudden there's a flurry by Carolina, and it's a 10-point game at halftime, and then it just went crazy in the second half. And most of those 33 and most of Cam Reddish's 27 came in what almost felt like garbage time. So he did not do himself any favors. So he's playing last night. So, Rob Parker, why does the NBA want to force these kids to play 1 year of college basketball? So they can observe this on big stages. This is like this is like minor league baseball at the highest level, or there's no minor league football, obviously.
Right.
But what a great opportunity it is for the NBA to avoid making mistakes, because if these kids had gone straight into the draft out of high school, RJ would have gone way above Zion.